Hey guys, so I'm on site and here's part of the sidewalk I got to do. So the face of it, the top of it. All right, we're going to do this all the way down the tennis court, and we're going to do it up to the basketball court. But we're not going to do the basketball court because we don't want to, he doesn't want to have to repaint. Okay, so that's part of it. Then we got the sidewalk here that comes down, all right? And mixes here, and you see this rust, we got to try to get this rust up, which I got some stuff for that. And then we got this sidewalk here that goes all the way down to that street lamp. Now I already did all that with the surface cleaner, and then I came back through with my water broom. So I'll show you guys in a little bit how that works, but I'm waiting for the HOA president to show up to unlock the gate. So I also have to do the pool deck. There's a pool deck here. There's a small pool back there. There's this deck here. And then there's these two buildings here that get bleached. So, I mean, I've been at it for 45 minutes and I already got a far stretch done. So now I'm gonna continue on here and get all this done because I want to be able to treat this bad rust. And that's the iron that's from the, it's not really rust, it's iron, which is rust. I mean, you know, whatever. But it's iron from the water from the soil and stuff like that. So the low spots here, the low spots there where the water sits, it's leaving iron. So we're going to get that up and do the best we can. When that dries, before I treat it, I'm going to try to take a before and after. So, but I want to let that dry. So this is the next worst or bad spot. So we're going to get this here now and head on down. And then over there, I'll show you guys how the surface cleaner works. By then, the HOA president will probably have been here and gone. So I'm going to get this sidewalk done, then I'm going to get this done. Then we're going to move into the pool area and just go from there. So far pretty good, about 45 minutes, and I already have a ass load of the concrete done. So that's good. So I will be back. Hey guys, so, all right, first impression of the, well, it's 10 o'clock, so I've been moving on a couple hours now. Got a lot clean. Got this whole sidewalk done, all the way down and around, all the way to that light pole. And then also have the face of the curb done. So that's all clean. That's all, like, I don't know what that is. That's just crap in the concrete. That's not dirt. That's like shit in their mold or something. I don't know. Oh, here's the HOA guy. I'll be right back. Okay, all right, so I'm back. So that whole sidewalk there is done on that side. I'm now working on this side here, going all the way down. And I've done from here all the way back. And then, so what I do is, I first hit it with the surface cleaner, and then I come back with the water broom and blow all the dirt off that came up and is now just settled. So I'll come back with the water broom and blow all that off, and we'll have a nice white sidewalk. So, let me go ahead and set up the tripod. And I'll go ahead and do some work here. This sidewalk's really not bad. But you see how it looks good there? It looks like new concrete up there. And then right here, it's got all the crap building up. So we're gonna get all this crap that's building up, we're gonna get all that off. So let me get the tripod and let you guys see this 20-inch surface cleaner in action. Now, I'm not sure if it's brand. I'm not sure if it's my pressure washer, being 4 gallons per minute, but I can say that this 20-inch surface cleaner sucks in comparison. Sorry, I'm gonna lose the view here, but sucks in comparison. I'm screwing you onto the tripod. To the 12-inch BE Whirlaway that I was using for a while, until I broke it. Coffee. As far as, what's the word I'm looking for? Quality and speed. This one wants to stripe if I start moving with any bit of a purpose. So I really have to go slow. Although it's a 20-inch cut instead of a 12-inch cut, you know, into the dirt cut, whatever. But it almost seems like because this is a 20-inch and I have 4 gallons per minute, it's almost like I'm not pushing enough power into this thing. But the 4 gallon per minute pump I have is awesome with the 12-inch BE whirl away. So right now my first thoughts is I'm not gonna go crazy about buying one of these 20-inch Mighty T 20-inch surface cleaners until I figure some things out. Now there's some things to think about when you're using wands. For example, I don't have my glasses, so I can't see what the hell this says. But somewhere in here, somewhere, probably says what gallons per minute this wand is. This trigger. All right. The one that I use all the time is a 10-gallon per minute trigger. So I have a 4-gallon per minute pump, a 10-gallon per minute trigger. So that means I have like zero restriction going to the tip or the 12-inch whirl away that I was using, the two tips. This might be 3 or 4. I don't know what this is. That could be an issue. It could also be that I had 200 feet of hose coming off the pressure washer, so I took 50 feet off. So I'm down to 150 feet, which is what I normally use anyways. But I needed that extra 50 feet for over there without having to move my truck. That could be an issue. So I'm going to try it now with 150 feet of hose, apples to apples, this straight up against the 12-inch that I'm used to. And we'll just have to see how it goes. So let me get this set up and see what we can do. And hopefully I won't get too much moisture on here. I'm going to put you right up here. And I'll go fire up my pressure washer and I will be right back. All right, so hopefully this will show good for you guys. And let's see if you guys can see the difference. Difference not having that extra 50 feet of hose on. but you can see the neat thing about the surface cleaners is I'm not hurting my back. This is super easy to do. You just gotta have patience, take your time, but it does a really good job. You know, compared to sitting there going back and forth with a wand with just the tip and doing it old school. I would never be as far as I am, and I would be in a lot of pain in my back right now. This is effortless, so let's just keep going for a little bit. It's a pretty good before and after. So obviously you can see how it works there. It does a good job, and then you just gotta come back and clean it off. Clean the loose stuff off. But all right, let me come back in a few minutes and we'll do a different angle. All right guys, so it's been about 20 minutes since I shut it down last. I finished this sidewalk, and what I did is I just did long walking passes all the way down and then all the way back. Instead of going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. That seemed to work out pretty good with this unit. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the water broom, and I'm going to clean all the debris off. So I'm going to let you guys see how that works. That's a neat little deal. Hopefully, I won't get my camera wet. I'm going to do the best I can, but I got to try to protect my camera as well. So I got it all connected. Let me fire it up, and then you guys can check out how the water broom works.
I'm coming. have four tips. So it's not like, it's not really for cleaning, it's just a brute.
Too much dirt in there.
All right, sorry about that. I'm back. Had to take the
four jets out. Tips. Clean them out. All right, check it out.
That works. Just cleans everything up.
Simple, huh?
You want to know if there's a difference with the surface washer? Look at that stripe I missed. So what I'll do is I'll just take the broom off and put my 40 degree tip on and hit that, and then clean up this curb right here. So that'll all be cut in nice. But anyways, that's how the water broom works. It just blows the stuff, you know, cleans it all out. Leaves, debris, built up crap. It's not strong enough to use as like a pressure washer, like to try to save time. It's not strong enough for that. But it is strong enough to move a whole lot of debris out of your way while you're working. So anyways, I'm gonna shut this down. I'm gonna do the face of this curb here with the 40 degree tip. And then we move into the pool house. All right, guys. We got all of the outside sidewalks done. The faces of the sidewalks are done where it meets the asphalt. Now we're in the pool area. So we're gonna do the kiddie pool first. We're all hooked up. And let's go ahead and do this. I'm gonna have to start conserving battery on this thing. So I'm gonna do what I can. But this is how we could do. Well, I'll wait till I get closer. I'll turn this back on. That took me about 15 minutes. Now I'm gonna blow it all off with the water broom and move on to the big pool area. So we still have some wetness out here, but I'm just trying to show. I mean, we're done. That's blew in some debris, whatever, leaves, but all the crap is up. I mean, this is a clean ass cool deck now. I'll tell you what, it's clean, but I still got some wet spots, so I don't know how that looks on camera. But yeah, I moved everything around, cleaned it up real good, letting it dry. And what I'm gonna do now is I got the whole porch here is done. So I just got the two buildings to do now. But all this is done. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna shut it down real quick and I'm gonna go return this sprayer or the surface cleaner. Let's see, all this is done. I'm gonna go return the surface cleaner and grab something to grub on a little bit. It's only 2 o'clock now. So I still got, you know, 3 hours of workable time, whatever. Wife's getting the kids, so I'm good there. So what I'm gonna do is go get some, basically I'm gonna go get some lunch, something to drink, go return this surface cleaner so I don't have to pay for another day. And let me load up and we'll talk about it in the truck. All right, so let me see where we're at here. Battery is still looking okay. But I'm gonna lose you pretty soon here. So like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and return this surface cleaner. Now I have enough money bid into this job. In fact, I'm surprised I got this job. I thought I overbid this thing. I was really shocked to get a call from the president saying go ahead and get it. Oh shoot, hold on 1 second. Okay, I didn't want to leave my yard sign here with me not working. This HOA is not going to sit there and play games with yard signs in their common grounds. But, I mean, I'm sitting there working, so I told her, I said to the prayer, I hope you don't mind. I'm going to have a yard sign up while I'm working, maybe drum up some business. So, yeah, I was surprised I got the call and was given the go-ahead to do it. Because I bid a lot. I mean, I bid a lot. And all that was, so far, besides the $30 rental, about $35 out of pocket, I filled my pressure washer one time. So I started with a full tank of gas, I ran it dry, and I filled it up with about 20 minutes to go. Maybe 30 minutes to go. So now I just gotta do the wash, the actual house wash part. I don't wanna rush it, and I wanna get the cleaner back, because the surface cleaner, because I don't wanna pay $70 for this thing if I don't turn it back in on time. And why I say that is at first it was like it was cool, but I don't know if my pressure washer is not strong enough, which 4 gallons per minute, I mean, that thing says use 3 to 5 gallon per minute pressure washers. It just doesn't, it's just not cutting the mustard like it should. My 12-inch BE Whirlaway, holy crap, man, it cuts into the dirt. I mean, it cuts good. And very, very rarely do I have it leaving, like, swirl stripes, because I'm moving faster than it's cutting and cleaning. Very rarely would that happen, and that would only be on really bad stuff. I mean, you could make that happen if you're an idiot, but I mean, if you're just doing a decent job, moving at a decent speed, I mean, you know, you weren't really going to get those swirl marks. So I was really surprised that this machine swirled as bad as it did, even at a slow speed, moving really, really slow. And the place isn't as bad as nearly what I've done in the past with other places. I mean, I've done some pretty nasty surface, you know, concrete. So this thing retails for, what is it, $375, I think it was. And I tell you, I wouldn't pay $375 for it. I wouldn't pay $250 for it. In fact, I'm not gonna rent it again. I don't think it's worth it. I don't know if it's my pressure washer not powerful enough or what, but it's just not moving the water away from the wand and the spinning wand. And so the spinning wand just starts slowing down. So it's like a freaking V8 motor with, you know, drop two cylinders. It's like, whoa, 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 whoa. You can hear it instead of instead of like a sound, like, I mean, that 12 inch would hum. That thing would be going so fast that, I mean, it would hum. This one, it was just like whoa, going around, and you have to stop and let it build up. You got to constantly be lifting it up. It's like the water just kept getting trapped under it. And even though it had all those openings, the water was just getting trapped under it, and I'm constantly stopping. This one is 20 inches. I can't help but think that my 12 inch, I would have been done sooner with my 12 inch than this 20 inch, because I would have been moving much more quicker. And it doesn't leave the water just sitting on top of the, I'm gonna jump out real fast and move my yard sign from the back of my truck into the back seat here so it don't blow out. Hold on 1 second, guys. Shit, light just turned green. All right, there we go. Shit, someone's calling me. Hang on, my wife. Yes, dear. Tired. I got all the concrete done, and you're on camera right now. I got all the concrete done. I'm going to return the surface cleaner. It's not worth a second rental day, so I'm going to go return it and then go back, and I just got to do the house wash part. Well, it's not worth it. Don't worry about it. I'll be in touch. I'm on camera. Love you. Bye. All right. So, where was I? Okay, hold on. So, I was her checking to see if I want her to bring me anything to eat or drink or something. So, which I'm dying of thirst. I've just been sipping my damn coffee all day. And, I mean, that's all I've had to drink all day, and it's still quarter full. And then I just got a bottle of water that's been in here for a couple days. I'm going to polish off. But, you know, I don't know. I think that pressure washer, that surface cleaner, I just don't think is a very good design. There's something wrong with it. So I'm going to pass on wanting that, and I'm going to not recommend it to others. I just don't think it's worth it. And I'm going to continue to recommend the BE Whirlaway. That's the name of the company, BE. Like, you know, hey, you be me, BE. So capital B, capital E, Whirlaway. Those are separate. Whirlaway. Surface cleaner. So that 12 inch I had was freaking phenomenal. And you just connect it right to your wand as a tip. So like this here, I don't have a ball valve on my pressure hose by my handle. So every time I wanted to switch from the surface cleaner to my wand and use either the water broom or just use the jet, you know, the 40 degree head or tip, I have to go back to my pressure washer, turn off the pressure washer, go back to whatever I'm using, release the pressure, take the hose off the handle, put the hose onto the new handle that I want to use, go back, fire up the pressure washer, go back to where I'm working. And I was at many points 200 feet away. So that's another thing that, you know, you got to take into account. Now, if you don't have a strong, powerful, at least 4 gallon per minute pressure washer, this thing would never work for you. Never work for you. So don't even do it unless you've got a really good pressure washer. So I'm going to kill this for now. At least you got to see a little bit of my work with the surface cleaner and how it worked. And it, you know, it's better than nothing. I'll say that. I mean, it's better than not having one, but it's definitely not worth purchasing. I'm glad I rented it and I learned about it, and I'm not going to do that again. So I'm going to haul ass to Home Depot, return it. Before I drink my water, and then just go back there and do the house wash part real quick, and then we'll do some final video of the place, show you the finished product, and that's it. And then the job also got much bigger too. He wants me to submit another estimate to do the entire tennis court, which I did a spot for him to show him how, you know, what a difference we can make, and also the entire basketball court. So I'm going to submit a bid to him for that, to get that done. So I got to do the house wash still, then I got to go back with my little mix of stuff and spray the iron stains that are on the concrete. Just go around, do a little bit of spot spraying, and let that loosen up some, and you know, that's it. So I'm going to spray that, and then while that's sitting, I'm going to go do the house wash, and then I'll go back and rinse that chemical off, and then that'll be it. So then I'll submit my invoice, and thank you. We'll be back. Okay, guys, I am done. I got $13 and some odd cents back on that rental on the $50 charge, so $36 and change was the total bill. So $36 to rent that unit, and I mean, I'm not sorry I rented it. I just know better than to buy it. There's another one I can rent that's $70 or $75 for the day. That's a lot of money. But it's like a $600 machine. I want to try that one. Because I really do want to make a good purchase this year, a good concrete purchase this year. Because this is a job I could send out. You know, I could have people doing this. I mean, this is easy stuff. Just you know, while I'm out mowing or something, you know, I could have pressure wash going on too at the same time. I have somebody I trust doing it, but it's not that big of a deal. I'm tired, man. It's 5:30. I started at 8. I've been up since 5:30 to get the kids ready for school. I'm pretty tired. I mean, I went 6 solid hours of that surface cleaner. And so now I just did the whole building. So let me show you guys real quick. So the building's done. Those high peaks are done. So everything up there is all done. Let me shut my door because kids over here smoking at a picnic bench. I don't want them, you know, sticky fingers. But the building's done. This rust is not as bad as it looks. It looks bad because it's wet. But when I pulled up earlier and it was dry, it looked a lot better. And now that was before I treated it. Now I treated it, it's going to look a lot better when it's dry. But I'm going to leave one more application on, and I'm just going to leave it. I'm just going to let it sit on it since it's nighttime and nobody's coming to the pool or anything like that. So did the roof. Those are holes. That's not dirt. But I did the roof, but I work around the fans. So you see the fans aren't wet. So you just kind of, you know, you kind of work around the fans. And, you know, if they need to get closer to that, they can get a house cleaner out here or something with a duster. The roofs around here are like really easy to do. It's mostly just like soot, you know, road dirt and stuff like that. So really, once you coat it nice light with the bleach, and you know, a little soap, a little bleach, you come back and you just rinse it real easy, it comes out really, really nice. You just gotta look for like spider webs and stuff like that in the corners. But there are a lot of freaking corners, and all these little dark spots that you see on the trim work, that's all nail heads. It's kind of weird, but I would have touched that up personally. But man, there's a lot of ins and outs here that I had to deal with. Between the two buildings, I mean, I'm doing a circle now. I mean, it's just a lot of crap to deal with here. It's deceiving. You know, you stand back, it's like, oh, that's super simple, but it's actually not super simple. It's actually pretty intricate to get everything clean and not, you know, destroy yourself and get soaked. And I managed to do it without getting wet. So you got a peak up there. That vent was like black. The gable vent, that was black. So that was really the worst thing about this whole building, was that gable vent. The back is done. So, I mean, it looks great. It's ready for the summer. We did the sidewalk from here all the way around. You see all the way up and around, all the way to the front of the building. It's a lot, man. It's a lot. So, but we are done. That gable vent's nice and clean now, so nobody has anything to complain about. Sidewalk really looks good. Really does. Really looks fantastic. He said it was about 15 years. I'm like, 15 years? I'm like, no way. He said, well, maybe like 7. I was like, okay, maybe 7 years since this has all been done. But it's all done, and the sidewalk out there by the tennis court, that's all done. And the face of it's all done. Remember how black the face of that was? I mean, look at it now. I'm not gonna get fancy and start doing before and after like still shots, because I just don't have the time and patience to do that crap. You can go back to the beginning of the movie, the video, and see what this looked like a while ago. The face of that was just pure black. It was all just pure black. So, but yeah, he wants me to do this tennis court. Give him a price on this tennis court. Look at that. Jesus criminy. Be there all day. Look how black that is. The green and the red. And then this is all done. So the face of this is done. And I will be doing a property lawn care bid here too. Pool looking pretty good. They need to repaint it. You can see like a lot of wear mark, a lot of finger marks on the on like the curbing there by the pool where people hold on. So they need to repaint this. This used to be the color of that. See how like orangey the color that is? A lot less traffic there. Here, it's, you know, a lot of foot traffic. And it's a saltwater pool too, which I don't know if you guys are not familiar with saltwater pools. They are freaking awesome. No chlorine burn. I mean, it's a lightly salted pool. They usually go through a sand filter, as far as I know. I mean, it's just amazing. The pools are amazing, saltwater pools. So it's got a little bit of water sitting there, but man, this was so nasty. But you see like all that, that's paint. It looks like it's rust, but that's paint sitting there. So this cool deck used to have nice paint. And that's all worn off. So I told him he's gonna have to repaint it. And this was just yuck black. So that's all done. So man, we did some serious freaking washing today. And then here's the other side of the clubhouse and everything. You see the gable vent up there. And then the back of the gym there. And the whole floor is done. The whole ceiling, roof, everything. Good Lord almighty. Well, not roof. Roof is fine. Man, I tell you, we worked our butts off here. So what do you guys think? You want to get into pressure washing? I'm tired. I told you, this was the biggest job I've ever landed. I'm pretty freaking tired. So I will see you guys later. Leave a comment below. What's up, dude?